Hello, welcome back. In this video, I'll be talking about how games are optimized. Before we start, I should let you know I'm not a developer, but I did research this very well, asking a few devs. They don't need to be popular, they are devs. Let's start with what is optimization. Google does a very good job explaining it. Optimization is the action of making the best or most efficient use of a situation or resource. Sounds good to me. So, how are games optimized? Let's go back for a minute. There is different ways to optimize a game. I'm going to list a few and talk about them, explain them. So there are more ways to optimize a game that aren't listed here to make the video short and save me from blind up. First the list, we're gonna talk about code, occlusion calling / frustum calling, enable instancing, and level of detail. We're gonna explain what are those in a sec. Good optimization means that the game works at the same frame rate across a wide range of hardware specs, including low-end configurations. This isn't really true. Let's replace same frame rate with acceptable, because you can't have the same frame rate of a GTX 550 compared to a 1080 in modern graphical intensive games. The word here is acceptable. Let's start with code. If a game is coded poorly, it can have a huge performance impact. Here's an example. The top code you see is a code that can be simplified to optimize performance. But of course, the more poorly coded code you have, the worse performance is going to be. The second one is the simplified version of the top one. It's much more easier to read it. Let me explain why the second code is better. If you did if and else, then it must check for the operation first, then assigns the value in. But the second one is just assigns the value into the corresponding values of those values. So assigns them directly, basically. Let me give you an example of this in English. Well, it's not quite the same, but it should give you at least an idea. Let's say I asked you to pour me 100 milliliters of water in a special cup. Of course, you would need to look for the special cup that I asked you to and then pour me water, or you can just pour water in any cup that can hold 100 milliliters of water, which is faster to do. That's the same way the code works, like if and else, so it needs to check that, and if it can't do that, then else just does what next step is. Occlusion calling and frustum calling. Frustum calling renders most of the things you look at. Let's say you are looking at three trees, then you move the camera a bit so that you don't see one of the trees, you only see two trees. The tree that you can't see and the objects behind the tree are still being rendered. This can hurt performance so much because you are rendering stuff that you don't see. On the other hand, occlusion calling does a better job. It only renders the objects that you see. So if we go back to the three tree example I used, the tree that you wouldn't be able to see and the objects behind the tree, or behind any tree, the objects that you can't see, they wouldn't be rendered until you move the camera and see the object, see the tree that's not rendered will be rendered. That improves performance like so damn much, and it's one of the easiest ways to optimize a game. Instancing. What you see is 100,000 objects at 60 FPS, like solid 60 FPS. How does it work and why don't we use it in everyday games, man? Not cool, man. Okay, so how it works is very simple. So normally when there's an object, when instancing is turned off or not in use, if there's the same object with the same textures and everything, normally the GPU needs to grab information for every single object, which is called the draw call, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong, it's called a draw call, and then it just renders it. What instancing does, it renders, it gets information once and then it duplicates the objects, then moves it into the right place. So why don't we use it? Well, there's a couple of drawbacks. It has to be the same object, obviously, because you are duplicating the object. so you don't do more draw calls, which will reduce load on hardware and improve rendering performance. Make the GPU do less work, hey! To get that boost, FPS boosting, I'm going off script. Go again, go again, go again, now we go again, boys, go again! Level of detail. Level of detail, or LOD for sure. It's used in almost all modern games. So normally when there's an object, a game object, it's made of polygons or different shapes to make the object. So when the object is normally further away, you don't see much detail because that's how things work. The smaller it is, the less detail you can see from an object, and that's the case in real life as well. It's not just the case in games, and then level of detail comes in. When there's an object that is far away from the camera, what level of detail does reduces the number of polygons used in the object. You won't notice it unless used on trees. That's it for today. Everything I covered in this video is supported by Unity and the Unreal Engine 4. I don't know about the other engines. Don't forget that there is more ways to optimize the game, but that was just a fun video. It's not aimed to tell developers how to optimize the game, it's just build curiosity. I have curiosity, you know, you watch a video like because you're curious. Stay curious, and I'll see you next time.